गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डू एमसीक्यूज मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू चैप्टर रेवेन्यू. ओके, सो लुक एट द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन इज रेवेन्यू इज इक्वल टू कॉस्ट माइनस प्रॉफिट, सेकंड इज कॉस्ट प्लस प्रॉफिट, थर्ड ऑप्शन इज कॉस्ट इनटू प्रॉफिट एंड फोर्थ ऑप्शन इज कॉस्ट डिवाइडेड बाय प्रॉफिट. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द राइट आंसर? रेवेन्यू इज इक्वल टू कॉस्ट प्लस प्रॉफिट. एज इन रेवेन्यू वी इंक्लूड कॉस्ट प्लस प्रॉफिट बिकॉज इन रेवेन्यू कॉस्ट एंड प्रॉफिट बोथ आर इंक्लूडेड. इफ वी एक्सक्लूड कॉस्ट फ्रॉम अवर रेवेन्यू देन वी गेट प्रॉफिट. ओके, एंड हाउ वी गेट प्रॉफिट? Profit is equal to revenue minus cost. Okay, so B is the right answer of this question. Revenue is equal to cost plus profit. Second question, for a perfectly competitive firm, what is perfectly competitive firm? A firm in which there is large number of sellers and large number of buyers and price is decided by the industry. So for a perfectly competitive firm, price is equal to greater than MR, equal to AR, equal to MR, D, both B and C. So what is the right answer? As we study that in perfectly competitive market, price is equal to AR because average revenue tells us the rate at which good is sell. Okay, and AR is equal to MR because TR increase in perfectly competitive firm at a constant rate. Okay, so difference is constant, so MR is also constant. MR is equal to AR, so both B and C both are right. Next question, select the correct equation. TR is summation of AR. Is it right? No, it is not right. Then MR is equal to change in TR upon change in Q. Can we calculate MR like this? What is the formula? Normally we use MR equal to TRN minus TRN minus 1. And we can also calculate marginal revenue like this, change in total revenue upon change in total output. Q means output. For example, earlier a consumer is selling 100 units, 10 units, okay? 10 units he is selling and that is equal to 100 rupees. So, TR is 100 and Q is 10. If Q 1 in, now Q increase 11 and it is 110, so we can calculate change in TR is 10 upon change in Q is 1. So 10 is our MR. We can calculate MR like this. Okay. So B is the right answer. Okay. Look at the second question. Average revenue can be negative. Second option cannot be negative. Is 0 when TR is 0, both B and C. Is 0 when TR is 0, can be negative, cannot be negative. So it can be negative, cannot be negative. It cannot be negative. Okay, it cannot be negative. And average revenue is 0 when TR is 0. So both B and C are the right option. Okay, next question. Under monopoly, marginal revenue can be negative only when AR is increasing, AR is decreasing, AR is constant, AR is zero. So what is the right answer? Under monopoly, marginal revenue can be negative only when average revenue is decreasing. So B is the right answer. Next question, which of the following equations is correct? Average revenue is equal to P into Q upon Q. Average revenue equal to P minus Q. Average revenue equal to P plus Q. Average revenue equal to P divided by Q. So what is the right answer? Average revenue is equal to P into Q. So what is P into Q? पी इंटू क्यू वी मीन टी आर बिकॉज इट इज इक्वल टू टी आर. सो टी आर अपॉन क्यू इज इक्वल टू ए आर. एवरेज रिवेन्यू कैन बी कैलकुलेट. सो ए आर इज इक्वल टू टी आर अपॉन क्यू. ए आर कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड टी आर अपॉन क्यू. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन ए इज द राइट आंसर. ओके लुक एट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. व्हेन एम आर इज जीरो देन टी आर इज मिनिमम टी आर इज मैक्सिमम टी आर इज जीरो टी आर इज इक्वल टू एम आर. व्हेन एम आर इज जीरो देन टी आर इज मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम. यस टी आर इज मैक्सिमम देन एम आर इज जीरो. एंड व्हेन टी आर स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग मीन्स द शेप ऑफ टी आर इज लाइक दिस. And when TR start decreasing, then MR become negative. And here TR is maximum, then our MR is zero. Okay? So answer is C. TR is maximum. When TR increase at a constant rate, MR should be increasing, decreasing, constant, zero. When TR increase, TR is increasing but at a constant rate. MR should be so in perfect competitive market what we discuss that TR increase at a constant rate in perfect competitive market and AR is equal to MR because MR is also constant when TR increase at a constant rate. So MR should be also constant. It will not be increasing or decreasing or zero. When TR increase at a constant rate, then MR should be constant only. Next question. Which of the following statement is appropriate in case of monopoly? So what is monopoly? Monopoly is a market situation in which there is only one seller and other are buyers. Okay. So there is a monopoly of that particular firm and we have the example in India, example of railway. Indian railway is an example of monopoly because it is having monopoly. AR curve slope upward while MR curve slope downward. Slope of both AR and MR is upward. So is it right or wrong? AR curve slope upward, MR slope downward. No. In monopoly, it is not the situation. AR curve do not slope of upward and MR slope downward. This is not the situation. Then second, slope of both AR and MR curve is upward. No, this is also wrong. Slope of both AR and MR curve is downward and MR is below AR. So this is the right line because what is the shape of AR and MR in monopoly? This is the shape of AR and MR. It is our AR and this is our MR. So MR is below the AR and both are downward sloping. So C is the right answer. Okay. Next question. Under perfect competition, MR curve is below AR curve. Price equal to AR equal to MR. AR remain constant both B and C. So MR curve is below AR curve. In earlier question we only discussed this is the situation of monopoly and monopolistic competition, not perfect competition. So in perfect competition, price is equal to average revenue and average revenue is equal to marginal revenue because marginal revenue is constant because TR is increasing at a constant rate. Okay, and AR remain constant because price AR is equal to price and price in perfect competition is decided by the industry and that remain constant. So D is the right option. Both B and C are correct. What is the shape of average revenue curve under perfect competition? So what is the shape of average revenue curve? It is the shape of average revenue is like this. It is like this. So what is this? This is horizontal to O axis. Horizontal to O axis. Okay. So horizontal straight line. This is the shape of average revenue curve in perfect competition. And in monopoly, average revenue is downward sloping. And in monopolistic also, it is downward sloping. MR is different from average revenue under perfect competition, monopolistic, monopoly, both B and C. So D is the right answer. Both B and C, monopoly and monopolistic competition, AR and MR is different. Both are downward sloping and different. MR is below the average revenue. Okay. Firm average revenue is the same as budget line, firm supply curve, firm demand curve, both B and C. Firm average revenue is the same as firm demand curve. Okay. So this is the right option. B is the right option because AR is average revenue is also the demand curve for the firm. Okay. Because price decide the demand for the goods. Average curve is more elastic under monopolistic competition than under monopoly. Average curve is more elastic. So what is the right option? First option is lack of close substitute, availability of close substitute, low degree of government control, high degree of government control. So availability of close substitute, because under monopolistic competition there is availability of close substitute. For example, Colgate, or we can say that Dabur Colgate and Simple Colgate, we have substitute. We can say in soap, Lux, Nirma, we can have close substitute. Instead of one brand, we can use product of other brand. If one brand is increasing price, then we will purchase goods of other brand. Okay. So there is availability of close substitute. These are example of monopolistic competition. When firm is able to sell more quantity of output at the same price than AR is greater than MR, AR is equal to MR, AR is less than MR, none of these. When firm able to sell quantity of output at the same price. So in perfect competition, AR means price is decided by the industry and all the firm follow that price and sell unlimited infinite quantity on this price. So firm is able to sell more quantity of output at the same price than AR is equal to MR. Margin revenue and average revenue both are equal. TR increase in MR is the rate at which TR increase, remain constant, diminishing, none of these. Increase in MR, as we discussed, this is the shape of TR and this is MR. So when TR is constant, then MR is zero here, and when TR is increasing, then MR is also increasing. So increase in MR is the rate at which TR increase. It is the rate at which TR increase. Or we can also say that how we calculate MR, TRN minus TRN minus 1. This is the formula. So this tells us the change, that how much change in TR. So MR is the rate by which we know how much change in TR increase. When output increase from 8 unit to 10 unit and TR increase from 270 to 300 times 300, the MR is increase, output increase from 8 to 10 unit, TR increase from 200 to 300, then MR, what is MR? There is change of 270 to 300, 30, change in TR is 30. And change in TR is 30. We can say delta TR equal to 30, 270 to 300. And change in Q is 2, so 15. So change in TR is 15. Or we can say this is our MR. MR is equal to 15. So C is the right answer. Okay. So students, these are some MCQs, multiple choice question related to your revenue chapter. So read the chapter and practice the diagram as much as you can do. Okay. If you have any problem, any doubt, you are free to ask. Okay. And also learn these questions and related also write the long answer question in your notebook related to this chapter. Okay, thank you students.